Hello students, today we will continue with the chapter number 6, editing and formatting text in MS Word. I told you in the last video that editing means making changes in already typed text. That means adding new text or deleting some unwanted text. Editing also includes copying and moving text. Copying means to create a duplicate copy of the original text. For example, we had typed some text in MS Word. Now from that text, we need some lines or text at another place also. We can copy that required text from one place and paste it at another place. This helps to save our time and efforts needed to type the same text again. Now let's see how it works. I had typed these steps to copy the text. Now I need the same steps under the heading Moving Text also. First of all, I will select the text that I want to copy, like I'm selecting here by dragging my mouse over the steps. Now, second step is click on Home tab, Clipboard group, Copy option. Home tab, Clipboard group, Copy option. Click here. Now, the third step is place your cursor at the point where you want to insert the selected text. I'm clicking here and pressing the Enter key. My cursor is there. Now, click on Home tab, Clipboard group, Paste option. Home tab, Clipboard group, Paste option. Now the steps had been copied. You can see that the same duplicate copy of the text has been created. Now if I want to make some changes to this text, I can make it. Like I want to write here, cut. And then here again, I am going to change the text as cut. And changing the shortcut key as X. That's it. I can also use the shortcut keys to copy the text. For example, I'm selecting this line by clicking in front of it. I can press the Ctrl plus C combination from the keyboard. Place my cursor where I want to paste the text. Suppose I'm having my cursor here. And press Ctrl plus V. The text has been copied. Like you can see, here copying and moving text, here also copying and moving text. Similarly, I can move the text or shift the text from one place to another. Moving means shifting the text from one location to another. For example, I want to shift this text. Select the text that I want to shift. Either press the Ctrl plus X key from the keyboard or click on cut option. I'm pressing here cut option. Now the text has been removed. I'm shifting it to another location. Suppose I want to paste it before copying the text. I place my cursor here. Make a line. Now click on paste option. Or press Ctrl plus V. Now you can see the text has been shifted. Okay, moving the text means shifting the text from one location to another. The next option that we will learn is undo and redo. Undo and redo. Both buttons are present on Quick Access toolbar. This is the undo button. And this is the redo button along with this save button. Save, undo, redo. Now, undo command is used to cancel the last action. The last action can be anything, whether you had accidentally deleted some text or whether you had formatted something, some text, or you had written some text, something accidentally I had written from the keyboard. Now I want to erase it. My last action is typing. So if I click on undo, it will cancel my last action of typing. If I accidentally delete some text, now my last action is deletion. I can cancel the last action by clicking on undo button or by pressing the Ctrl plus Z shortcut key. Similarly, redo button is used to cancel the last undo command. The action that you had cancelled by using the undo command, you want to do it again. So you can press the redo button or by pressing the Ctrl plus Y. For example, I had selected this text and changed its color to red or make it bold. Now, if I want to cancel the last action, that will be the bold. I press undo. Now, action has been undo. Now, to cancel this undo action and make the text bold again, I will press redo button. Redo will cancel the last undo action. Clear? After editing, our next topic is formatting text in MS Word. Formatting means changing the appearance of the text to make it look more beautiful. We can format the text by changing its font, font size, font color, or make it bold, underline, or italic, or by applying some special text effects. We can also highlight the text. All the major formatting options are available in the font group under the Home tab. You can this same font group here. This is the Home tab. This is the font group, and all these options can be used to format the text. Like, this is your font option, this is your font size, grow font, shrink font, change case, clear formatting, font color, text highlight color, text effects, superscript, subscript, strike through, underline, italic, and bold. We can use all these options to format the text. The steps are very simple. Select the text that you want to format. That means select the text that you want to change the color or font or make it bold or underline. For example, I had selected this text. I can change its font size by clicking here. I'm changing the size, that means changing the height of the letters. When I change the size, I'm changing the height of the letter, how big or small it should look. I'm changing the size. There are many sizes. Choose the size that you want and click it. Simple. Select the text. Click on font group, home tab, font group, font size button. Choose the size that you want for your font. Similarly, you can also choose the font color. Select the text, click on font color button, choose the color that you want. For example, I'm changing it to blue color. I can have more color here. For example, I'm selecting it again and changing the font color. I'm going to more color option. More color will give you two tabs, standard and custom. Standard, a few colors are there. I can choose any color from here, with whatever color I want. Or I can go to the custom and make my new color. I can click anywhere to make a new color, make it lighter or darker. Choose a shade, make it lighter or darker, click on OK. Here, click anywhere. Now the color of the font has been changed. Similarly, I can format this steps to change the font R. I can change its font by clicking on the font button drop down arrow, choosing any font that I like. A preview is there. For example, I'm taking this font. I can go down here also. There are many fonts available. You can go through all these fonts and choose the font that you want. I take this font. I'm changing its size. I can also make it bold. Just remember that your text should be selected when you apply these effects. Underline. I'm changing its color also. I can go to more colors, choose the custom color or standard colors. Click on OK. See, the text has been formatted. Clear? Select the text that you want to change. Click on Home tab, Font group, and choose the font, font size, font color. Or you can also make them bold, italic, and underline. One thing more, you can also change the size of the font by using these two buttons. This is your increase font size button, and this is your decrease font size button. Or you can say grow font and shrink font. One method is I can choose the font size from here, exact size 14. And I can also click on grow font, it will increase the size by 2 points like this. And I can click on decrease font size to make it small. Okay, now practice all these formatting features at your home. We will discuss the next formatting features in the next video.